Muhammad alayhi salam.
So Muhammad coming to our Nawi community, what about like, you know, education? Like, you know, how can we get this up like really to start to focus more in education? What's happening now, actually maybe girls are doing a little bit better than boys in education, but overall as a community, we're not doing as good as the other communities.
Yeah, well, that's excellent. I think what really lacks in our community is mentorship, you know, and I'm speaking this from my own experience when I was young. Right after high school, I probably changed my major 3 times. And I was in college for like a year and a half, like 3 semesters. Then I said, you know what? I'm done. Let me just work, get fast money. And then, you know, I was making whatever, $125 a day, thinking this is amazing at that age. Of course, I was not paying rent or anything. But not till later year of my life, when I was like 28 years old, where someone told me that there's a difference between a job and a career. Where they said, Muhammad, you have a job now. You don't have a career. And I'm like, what's the difference? And then they explained it to me. That's like, okay, I have to go back to college now. But I think that's what we're missing today in our communities. We don't have real mentors, right? That, you know, gets us while we're young in high school, that goes there, gives us a blueprint that if you want to become an engineer, this is the way to go, right? If you want to become a doctor, this is the way to go. If you want to become a lawyer, this is the way to go. If you want to become a nurse or anything, this is the way to go. It's just you have just, you know, hundreds and thousands of young people coming out of college with just no guidance at all. And when they're there, that's when they're supposed to see what they want to do. And what happens is that they start getting frustrated because they already spent 1 year doing something. And then when someone tells them, oh, now you could do this career, they're like, okay, now they apply for that career. And they're told, oh, that whole previous year of classes are not going to be accepted. So they're like, I just wasted 1 year of college, now I have to start over. Then they're like, you know what, forget it. I'm just going to do, you know, liberal arts or something. But what I think we need a lot more mentors in our community to sit down with the young generation and just give them that blueprint that this is what you want to do if you want to become this and that.
But how can we really implement this mentorship? How really to have to integrate it between the mentors and the young people? How can we do this?
Yeah, and I think that's the problem. And thing is, I think we I think that's why we have to create spaces or create an environment where we attract these young people to come here, or we go to them. And I think that's the problem sometimes, that we expect the young generation to come to us, all right? But that's not really the effective way of change. You know, if you want to change someone, if you want to create an impact, you have to go where the people are. Right, you have to go where the work is. So I think it comes really with first creating, you know, spaces, creating environments or even programs to attract, you know, the young generation. And then from there we start giving them a little bit of knowledge, right, trickling down or subliminal information where they start developing that trust, right? Because that's what I think that's what needs to happen. The young generation has to develop that trust with the elder generation, where they say, you know what, this person wants best for me, so let me listen to what they have to say, rather than saying, oh, this person just wants me to do this, this, and that, they don't care about me. So I think that trust has to develop first before anything. Yeah.
So I think with the community leaders, we have to really like implement this one, like really like to have a platform. Absolutely. To invite our young people.
Absolutely, it's their responsibility, and that's why they're community leaders. They have to provide those spaces for sure.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.